Hi everybody, Henry at Tech Advisor, and you're here because you want to know about the OnePlus Nord 2T 5G. We've got one, we're going to unbox it and take a look, give you some of my first impressions about OnePlus's latest mid-range phone for Europe. So we have the official retail boxing for the OnePlus Nord 2T 5G. I'll stop saying 5G now because a lot of phones do have that, but that's what you get with this mid-ranger. So it's quite a nice box. You get Nord coming across there, the name of the brand's mid-range phones. And what have we got on the back here? So I have that phone. We've got 8 gigs of RAM and 128 gigs of storage. I'll find out if it's micro SD in a minute. And we've got the Jade Fog version. I think that's a fancy way of saying it looks green. And there's a gray black one as well. Box is pretty nice, unopened. Get my trusty scissors out. Let's have a look inside. Cool, so you're presented with what you'd normally expect in a phone package. Of course, some brands these days don't give you a charger. Let's find out whether or not you get one in the box. So before I delve into the phone, we have a case, little TPU, that'll do. Probably all your normal papers and such. Safety information, gotta be safe with phones these days. Little Nord card from the Nord team, telling you about the old OnePlus Nord 2 and saying how great it is that you've got the new one. OnePlus, of course, going back to their naming convention of putting a T on the end. So while we might have thought that this would have been the OnePlus Nord 3, because it's about a year since the Nord 2 now, this is in fact the Nord 2T, which suggests it's only an iterative upgrade on the old one, a bit like how Apple used to do S versions. So this is the Nord 2. Do we get a charger? Yeah, we do. You're familiar now. OnePlus red USB-C cable. And here we have that what I'm reliably informed is an 80-watt Super VOOC charger. Now, OnePlus and its sister company, Oppo, are owned by the same company. You probably knew that if you're on this channel, BBK Group. Now, OnePlus used to call Warp Charge for its charging, and then it called it Dash Charge for a bit. But now it's kind of merging a bit with Oppo and how it does stuff. So this is named the same, but it's good to see 80 watt wired charging on this phone, which is the same as the OnePlus 10 Pro. So you're getting a premium feature there in this mid-ranger. Looking a bit messy, get that out of the way. Here's what you've been waiting for. This little icon here shows us that we've got an in-display fingerprint sensor, but we're pretty used to that these days, even on mid-range and even budget phones as well. So we have a gloss glass back. I was personally hoping for a matte finish. That's always quite nice. You don't see the fingerprints as much. But I mean, glass sticks in the hand a little better. And with this color, what's it called? Jade Fog? It's like a minty green, really. A pastel. You're probably not going to see many fingerprints on there anyway. Let's get all these stickers off. There you go. Let's have a little look at that. It's always a bit of a shame in the UK, where I am, but also in Europe, you kind of get these marks, these regulatory marks on the back of phones. In the US, you don't see those as much, and it's quite smart. But as far as we know, this is actually only coming to Europe at the moment. So you'll have to deal with it, or put your case over it and cover them up anyway. The phone is quite nice. Feels good. It's good size. There's no headphone jack here. Unfortunately, in a weird way, you now only get headphone jacks on the cheapest phones if that's a feature that you want. You do have the OnePlus Alert slider, which you'll pretty much only find on OnePlus or on an iPhone these days for quickly silencing those calls. I think it's a great feature and more phones should copy it, to be honest. Even Oppo phones don't have them. Otherwise, this is kind of a slab vibe. I don't know if you ever saw the Huawei P50 Pro series, but these cameras look quite similar. They've gone for two big discs there. And you've actually got a main sensor up here by the looks of things, and then two hidden in this other circle down here, and some other writing that I can't quite read there. DOL HDR, Dolby and HDR for the audio and for the camera there, I think. But we can't really tell anything more about this phone until I turn it on and have a look at the software. So let me just punch in all my details and we'll have a look at what the Nord 2T has got on the inside. So let's take a quick look at the software. Now, as I said earlier, OnePlus and Oppo are owned by the same company, BBK Group. And there was a lot of outrage in the OnePlus community recently when BBK suggested that OnePlus phones would start running Color OS, which is Oppo's software. Now, they've changed that. They're not going to just plaster that on and take away Oxygen OS, which is what so many people loved about OnePlus phones. But now OnePlus phones do actually run Color OS, but with a skin of Oxygen OS over the top. So you're still going to hopefully get the feel that you got from OnePlus phones, because the stock software was always what people really loved, including myself. So looking at the Nord here, you've got a pull-down option at the top right corner. It's kind of something that a lot of Android brands have copied from Apple, if I'm being honest, and that brings you to the shelf, which is OnePlus's little place that they put all the widgets that you can use. Then obviously pulling down, you'll get the Android 12, as we have here. Overlay. And I mean, there's nothing too unexpected about OnePlus's Oxygen OS at the moment. You've got a normal app tray and everything that you'd expect from Android 12. Obviously the Google Suite, no problem there. Let's have a little look at the hardware though. So as I said earlier, it's a glass back, but you don't actually get wireless charging. It's one of the concessions for spending this amount on a mid-range phone instead of a premium phone that could cost two, maybe even three times more. But of course, we've got the 80 watt wired charging, which is going to fill up the phone pretty quickly. On the inside, you've got a MediaTek Dimensity 1300. So you've not got Qualcomm Snapdragon here, but MediaTek has really upped its game recently, not only with the quality of its hardware, but also with the prestige of the brands that it's working with. The fact that the Nord is rocking it shows you that it's going to be hopefully pretty good. We'll put that to the test, of course, in our full review. Now, what did I have here? I had the 8 GB version of RAM. Normally fine, unless you're really taxing your phone, really pushing it with games and such, 8 should be fine, but there is a 12 GB RAM version available as well. And this one is, again, the lower end model with 128 GB of storage. You can also get 256. Otherwise here, it's good to see at this price that there is a high refresh rate display, so everything is going to look a little bit smoother than if you had a 60 Hertz display. This is a 90 Hertz display. So it's not quite as high as the 120 or the 144 that you'll see on those really premium or gaming phones, but it does mean that when you scroll and in some apps, the screen refresh rate is higher. That might affect battery life a little bit, but you do have a battery of 4,500 milliamp hours, which is pretty big considering this is a mid-range phone. You're not going to need too much more than that. And the fact that you can top it up so quickly should be pretty great. You've also got a single hole punch camera in the top there. And as you can see, because of the edges around it, it comes with a pre-installed screen protector. So that's always nice to see. Cameras around the back, I'm not going to be able to comment on those having just unboxed the thing, but we do have a 50 megapixel main sensor around the back, which uses the Sony IMX766, if that means anything to you, but it's a reasonably good sensor. And I usually, okay, I'm sorry, I will put this to the test in a full review, but usually on mid-range phones like this, the other two sensors are probably slightly cheaper and they're probably fine, but particularly the macro lens is not going to be too much to write home about. But the main sensor with 50 megapixels, you should definitely in good sunlight be able to get some pretty good shots out of this. It's going to be better than if you get a budget phone, of course. So thanks, that was a quick tour and unboxing of the OnePlus Nord 2T5G, the latest mid-range phone from OnePlus that is out soon, and it's in Europe and the UK. Now, it's pretty promising. It's got a 50 megapixel camera. I'm not sure about the fingerprints on the back, but this color should hide them nicely, and we will have a full review soon on techadvisor.com, so stay tuned for that. If you like what you saw here, please like and subscribe so you see all our upcoming videos. Until the next one, thanks for watching.